Where are we, Ray?
You clueless.
You don't have a clue? Ooklulet?
Ooklulet.
It's about
the Ookie Festival.
The Ookie? Uh-huh. And this is about July 12th?
July 12th.
Yes, I think those are the huckleberries. And then these are the evergreen huckleberries here with the shiny leaves, right? Mm. But no huckleberries on it. And these berries right here are sisal, right?
Salal.
Salal?
I think so.
Salal. Basically everywhere along the west coast here. There's a trail down there. Yeah.
Walking around with some boardwalk trails.
Yeah. Hello?
Oh, should we pose? Wildlife.
Yes, the biggest wildlife we've seen.
There's some neat starfish down there.
Yeah? Okay.
Yeah, so.
This leads down right here?
Yeah, it goes right down to the water. And
Okay.
You can explore from there.
Okay, great.
Well, you found climbing rocks. If you lift any rocks, you'll find
Look at
crabs.
This.
Yeah.
Find oh, crab claw. Oh. Okay.
You lift rocks, you find lots of crabs.
We'll look for them.
Lots.
Okay. Anemones,
yeah,
too?
Yeah, we lift it. We found okay. like a dead crab like this big. No, like this big.
I touched a live crab.
Well, you touched the right end, right? Without the claw.
Yeah.
I touched the back.
Okay. You scoot away pretty good. See you. Have a good time. Yes. This will be the last of the Pacific Ocean that we see for a bit. Sounds like bald eagles.
Sure they don't.
He's right up at the top of that snag. He's sort of in back of a branch looking out towards sea.
Where'd all those crabs go?
Ran away.
Yes, there's a starfish next to my hand. And there's a crab right there.
Hold it up, I want to take a picture.
I'm not sure which one. This one's kind of cool. I think I definitely want the flash, right? Okay. His tentacles on the rock. The crab's under there. Are you still filming?
There they go. Fast, don't they? Sure want to get to that rock.
Going for your toes.
I'm only going for under my toes. Plenty of snails dropping around. Are those are probably not snails at all, are they? They're crabs, hermit crabs. So you want to go down those steps, huh? Quite a nice little fern grotto here. Quite moist. These are deer ferns, right?
I think so.
Not the sword ferns. Sword ferns are bigger and coarser, I think. This is the return trail that we're coming back on, and this is about the end of it, I think.
We're in the rainforest.
Yep. Scrumped cabbages off the side of the trail here. That's a little one. There's been some really big ones here and there. End of the road.
Okay, lose the sunglasses. Yes? Jim really is here.
We're going 150 miles an hour though.
I'm driving too.
It's pretty pleasant out here. We're crossing the Georgia Strait. We're heading across from somewhere on the other side of Georgia Strait to the other side of the Georgia Strait. You know, Powell River. You know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Little River, Comex.
Comex. Ray was sort of in a hurry to get out of there. It was kind of busy. And it's the side that much of Vancouver drives up to get to their summer places. The other side over here has a couple of ferries. You have at least one ferry away, probably two or three ferries away from the point that we're going to right now. So it's probably a little bit more laid back. And we're hoping that even at 8:30 at night we can drop in on a Saturday, midsummer, and find someplace to stay. I guess it would be a little bit optimistic. So far, it's been working. So we'll try it out. Snow-capped mountains back in the distance.
here that we can see by looking up at Jarvis Inlet. A little tough to pick out because of the haze, but there, you can see some snow on the peaks back there. And so Jarvis Inlet separates this part of this is what we call the Sunshine Coast from the place as far north, or the northern portions of the Paul River. So, we made it across without sinking. Now I need to navigate, so bye for now.